Land use and transportation considerations for the chloride impact study conducted by the Southeastern Wisconsin Regional Planning Commission. Ever wonder what all that extra salt on roads does to the environment? Have you ever noticed all the salt on vehicles after a heavy winter? Imagine what that's doing to the environment. Road salt and de-icers contribute to high chloride levels in the environment. High chloride levels are corrosive to cars and bridges and are harmful to terrestrial plants along roadways, sidewalks, and parking lots. At really high levels, chloride in groundwater can be detrimental to drinking water wells. Chloride is also detrimental to aquatic organisms in streams and lakes. It is therefore of significant concern that existing methods of addressing water pollution cannot remove chloride from surface or groundwater resources, nor are there any natural processes that remove sodium and chloride ions from contaminated runoff or other discharges. The chloride impact study will take into account information on land use and transportation within the Southeastern Wisconsin region. Doing so will allow the study to consider the impacts of development on chloride loads in surface waters and groundwater. There are numerous potential sources for chlorides in the environment, which can be affiliated with urban or rural development. These sources include water softeners, sewage treatment plants, large animal feedlots, fertilizers, and landfills. Other potential sources include chemical manufacturing and food processing facilities. As previously noted, salt storage areas and de-icers used on paved surfaces are a significant source of chloride in the environment. As the impacts of chloride sources can vary depending on the density of development, the chloride study team placed monitoring sites to evaluate various contributing land uses. The team classified each monitoring site as being within an urban or rural drainage area, and used the site classifications when performing event sampling. Monitoring sites within urban drainage areas measured chloride loads in areas with more dense development that tended to contain more paved surfaces, including parking lots and wider roadways. Monitoring sites within rural drainage areas measured chloride loads in areas featuring more natural landscapes and large agricultural expanses used as feedlots or fertilized for food production. Monitoring sites within these relatively undisturbed landscapes provide information about water quality conditions in streams that are subject to fewer human impacts. The study will also consider the impacts of water softeners in both types of drainage areas. This is important because water softeners are used in urban and rural areas throughout the region that are reliant on groundwater for their water supply. In addition to considering existing urban and rural conditions, the chloride study will evaluate the use of chlorides for the region's anticipated growth. While the conversion of agricultural lands to urban uses may result in less chloride from feedlots or fertilizers, expansion of the roadway system to serve such urban development would most likely lead to the increased use of de-icers for new paved surfaces. In considering the potential changes in land uses and the transportation network, the chloride study can evaluate how the region might best minimize the future potential sources of chloride to protect our surface water and groundwater resources. Findings and recommendations from the study will be documented in technical reports and additional means to make the study available to a diverse audience. Visit the project page at www.sewrpac.org/chloridestudy or email Laura Herrick for more information.